The Founder is a 2016 American biographical drama film directed by John Lee Hancock and written by Robert Siegel. Starring Michael Keaton as businessman Ray Kroc, the film portrays the story of his creation of the McDonald's fast food restaurant chain, which eventually involved forcing out the company's original founders to take control with convening ruthlessness. Nick Offerman and John Carroll Lynch co-stars McDonald's founders Richard and Maurice McDonald, alongside Linda Cardellini as Ray Kroc's third wife, Joan Smith, and B.J. Novak as McDonald's president and chief executive, Harry J. Sonneborn. The film premiered at the Arclight Hollywood on December 7, 2016, and was released theatrically in the United States on January 20, 2017, by the Weinstein Company. It grossed $24 million worldwide against a budget of between $7 and $25 million, and received generally positive reviews from critics who praised Keaton's performance. The screenplay for The Founder was written by Robert Siegel, based on Ray Kroc's autobiography and his unauthorized biography. According to early reports, the film was to be developed in the same vein as There Will Be Blood and The Social Network. According to Deadline Hollywood, it was ranked 13th best unproduced script of 2014. In December 2014, John Lee Hancock was signed to direct the picture. In February 2015, Michael Keaton was signed on for the lead role of Ray Kroc, with Laura Dern joining the cast on May 11, 2015 to play Kroc's wife, Ethel Fleming, whom Kroc divorced in 1961. Production designer was Michael Korenbluth, who had previously worked on films such as Apollo 13 and Saving Mr. Banks, in which attention to historical detail was important. Korenbluth worked from archival photos, training films, materials provided by the McDonald family, blueprints obtained from eBay, and the research of the oldest McDonald's restaurants in Downey, California. The McDonald brothers' original octagonal San Bernardino restaurant was built in Noonan in the parking lot of Coweta County Administration Building. After a month of searching for a suitable location, an old-style McDonald's building set with the golden arches was constructed in a church parking lot in 7 working days in Douglasville, Georgia. The set included a working kitchen with a period-accurate kitchen equipment that was brought up to current code. Rearrangement of exterior features such as the parking lot strip allowed the set to serve as in each franchise location portrayed in the film. Both interior and exterior portions of the restaurant were modular, allowing countertops or entire wall-sized glass panes to be removed to make room for cameras and other equipment. Some interesting facts. The company Kroc worked for prior to founding McDonald's, Prince Castle, still exists and supplies McDonald's with much of its equipment. Dick and Mac McDonald had different responses to Kroc's actions. Dick moved back to New Hampshire and was relatively okay about selling McDonald's. He would even eat the ceremonial 50th billion hamburger in 1984. He was, however, bothered by how Kroc called himself the founder and referred to the Des Plaines location as the first McDonald's, even though it was actually the ninth. Mac, on the other hand, never got over Kroc's actions and died 10 years after selling the company due to his heartache and stress over the sale. Ray Kroc's discovery of McDonald's was not his first attempt at franchising. According to the book In-N-Out Burger by Stacey Perman, Kroc approached Los Angeles Apple Pan restaurant in 1949 and Carl Kuchner of Carl's Jr. prior to convincing the McDonald brothers. Tom Hanks turned down the role of Ray Kroc, and Michael Keaton took the part instead. This is the opposite of what happened in Philadelphia in 1993, when Keaton turned down the role of Andrew Beckett and Hanks took the part, eventually winning an Academy Award for Best Actor for his performance. Even though the Golden Arches were Dick McDonald's invention, while pitching the idea for the Des Plaines location, Ray Kroc said he called it the Lit Arches the Golden Arches. However, Dick McDonald's idea had the arches separated. It wouldn't be until Ray Kroc took over the company that the golden arches would be combined to form the iconic M symbol. It has been heavily disputed whether or not the McDonald brothers ever asked for 1% of the annual profits as part of the buyout agreement. After all, it was no risk venture for them, and essentially just as a finder's fee in a licensing agreement, so their $2 million fee plus whatever they earned from previous share of sales was very profitable. It's been theorized that the 1% was made up by some of their heirs who would have become billionaires had they taken this. Now, I found this to be a smart, satisfying biopic that traces the rise of one of America's most influential businessmen and the birth of one of its most far-reaching industries. I mean, there's literally very few people in this world that haven't had a McDonald's or don't know what McDonald's are. They can literally be found in almost every country in the world. And this is through and through all due to Ray Kroc. The name of the film and the name that he referred to himself as the founder can be misleading. He was the founder of the McDonald's franchise. And one of the most fascinating aspects in the movie, when Harry J. Sonneborn, played here by B.J. Novak, says to Ray Kroc, "You're not in the food industry, you're in the real estate industry." And that really sums it up perfectly. McDonald's became about real estate. Ray Kroc envisioned the idea of selling you the land, the building, the logo of McDonald's, and letting it become your own business while you made the food and sold it off. It was ingenious now to create, for example, the McDonald's School, allowing franchise owners to learn the exact methods of how to go about being a successful franchisee. So no, Ray Kroc didn't exactly find the idea of making a quick burger for people to eat and enjoy, but what he did do was expand it, make it into a global franchise network that now, of course, like I said, is almost in every corner of this earth. Ray was ruthless, manipulative at times, and very ambitious, but then again, this is part and parcel of capitalist business. It really does serve the strong. It's a game of survival of the fittest, and Ray was just two steps ahead of the much more passionate, yet naive, Richard and Maurice McDonald. It all depends how you look at the film. You can admire Ray Kroc for his vision and the way he took this company and made it into this global force, but you can also look at him and say he was cruel and unkind. But then again, I suppose that's what they call just doing business. Michael Keaton turns out another stellar performance here. Keaton plays these kinds of roles perfectly, a sort of quirky, offbeat kind of style that suits him down to a T. I thought the rest of the cast were on point too, from Nick Offerman and John Carroll Lynch as the McDonald's brothers, and of course BJ Novak, nice to see him outside of the familiar office role. Laura Dern wasn't really in the film much, so I couldn't really rate her, and neither was Linda Cardellini. All in all, it's a well-made, interesting film, though I found this would probably be done better if it actually played out as a documentary. It's kind of a film that tells you the story but really doesn't go anywhere per se. It's not one of those biopics that you're going to remember in great detail one day, as there's no huge drama or spellbinding moments to take your breath away, which unfortunately you become so reliant on and almost expect in modern day films. Like I said, the acting is solid, the film writing is good, the cinematography is well done, and I believe the attention to detail in terms of representing the history, particularly in the 50s, is very accurate and well done, with a few Hollywood slants just put on for effect. This is a good, easy, solid film to watch, but not a film in the same breath that will blow your socks off. The Founder gets an 8 out of 10.